Hi Sagittarius, welcome back to my channel, Queen of All the Trade. It's your girl, Miss Supermodel, and today I have your 3-day forecast for November the 24th to November the 26th, okay? So if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do so and click that notification bell so that you guys can get updated and notifications whenever I upload any new content, okay? Also, you guys can check the Sun, Moon, Rising, and the Venus sign videos to gain more information on your situation, okay? And also, if this video resonates with you, comment down below. I respond to all comments. And I hope that you guys had a very happy holiday, okay? Because I really did enjoy mine. And if you guys want a personal reading, all my information is down in the description box below. Okay? So just feel free to message me for the personals, okay? That's what we do. Let's get right into your read. With my shuffle. At the bottom of the deck, you have the Nine of Wands. You have the Emperor. Scorpio just got the same card in the same position. The Knight of Coins. Ace of Cups. Three of Cups. Okay. Oh, so some of you guys are looking for some, you know, financial stability, okay? You're looking for something to be, you know, very stable in your life currently at the moment, okay? With this Emperor here, this is telling me that you're trying to gain control over a situation, okay? You're trying to gain control in your life. What you can be trying to gain control of is, is moving forward with a very stable offer to somebody, and it's going to be a romantic offer, okay, a new opportunity in love, one that you guys can be joyous and happy and celebrate with, okay. It could be with a friend, okay. This could be with a friend that you want to offer this to, okay. But you come in slow and making this offer because you want it to be you want it to be long lasting, okay. In some of your cases, you're trying to gain control over a situation because somebody is trying to make they're coming towards you with a romantic, you know, with a new romantic opportunity, but this person is dealing with somebody else, okay. This person is already in a situation, Okay, so that's another scenario. So let's see what we got going on. Yeah, we have the Five of Wands. The Ace of Wands. The Ten of Cups. The Ten of Wands. Four of Swords. Seven of Swords. Queen of Coins. And we have the Ten of Coins, okay? So basically what I see here with all these is that I see that you could be dealing with a person. This could be the father of your child or, you know, or you could be in the masculine energy. But basically, you know, you could have been in a controlling situation with a person, okay, and it caused some type of conflict, and it caused for you guys to take a break, okay? But some of you guys are trying to gain control over a situation that, gain control over an argument or some type of confusion or conflict that you had with a person that you're dealing with that you want break from, okay? I see that you want to come and make a stable offer to them, but you're moving slow and you want to make them an offer. You want that to be a brand, you know, you want to make them an offer, a brand new, creative, passionate endeavor, okay? But you're moving slow towards this person because you feel like there was some type of deception or you could have been arguing and y'all took a break, you know, due to deception, okay? So the reason why you're moving slow with making this passionate offer towards this person is because there was some type of deception. This person was being sneaky, okay? But you ready for this financial, I mean, but you ready for this new opportunity in love, okay? Okay? You're ready for a new opportunity in love, okay? One that gives you happiness. One that you could be very happy with, okay? And one that is very stable. Like I said, you're ready for something stable. You're ready for stability in your life, okay? Sagittarius, something that's very stable. This could be with, you know, the parent of your child. You can have kids with this person, okay? In some of y'all cases, y'all got kids with this person. And for some of y'all cases, y'all ready to offer, y'all want a new romantic opportunity with a person, the person that makes you happy. You know, this is the ultimate love, this Ten of Cups, okay? This is the divine love. This person makes you happy, and this person is a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, okay? Or they have that in their chart. Okay, and they have that in their chart. But the person that you probably want to make this offer to, this passionate offer and this romantic offer to, could already be in a relationship with someone else, okay? And that's a burden, you know, that is the burden. Because you want a commitment with this person, okay? You're ready to have a family with this person, but this person is with somebody else, okay? And you're ready for this commitment. But some of y'all, I see that you was in a controlling situation. It was always conflicts and fights in this situation. You was arguing in this situation with this person that caused y'all to break up, okay? That caused for that to be some type of rest. That caused for you to go and for you to go and meditate and, you know, rest your mind and give this relationship a rest, okay? For some of y'all, it's the Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn person that's coming in slow to try to make an offer to you. Okay, and they want to make a passionate offer to you, but they being deceptive. They being deceptive about it, okay? They being deceptive about this this new partnership that they trying to offer you, okay? They being deceptive about the way they feel about you, about having this Ten of Cups with you and having stability with you, okay? Because this person is in a relationship with somebody else. And it's too much. It's too much. They committed elsewhere. They can't have a family this place and have a family that place. They have to choose. Okay, so that's the second scenario. But for some of y'all that's dealing with this person, that you're trying to gain control over the situation because y'all was having arguments in a relationship that took a break. You know, you're ready to make an offer to them, but you wanted to be stable, like I said. And you ready to make a whole new offer with somebody else. That you're ready for it to be stable. You're ready for passion. You want somebody to offer you passion. You're ready for that, okay? But it's just too much shadiness going on. It's just too much shadiness going on. Somebody lying. And all you want is stability. All you want is stability, but something is going to be illuminated. Okay, with this moon coming up, something is going to be illuminated. And I'm pretty sure that it's the fact that this person is dealing with somebody else. And it's too much. Okay, or you're dealing with somebody else and it's too much. Yeah, it's too much. It's a burden. It's putting a burden on the family. Like, it's putting a burden on this commitment. But some of y'all already in a partnership with this person, but y'all took a break. And because they was dealing with somebody else, you know, it put a burden on y'all, you know, on y'all, in your relationship. That's why y'all had to take a break. But this person is going to come back. They're going to come and offer you passion. They're going to come and offer you love. Because they feel like you're that Ten of Cups. And you feel like you're that Ten of Cups, okay? Whoever this person is, they are Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. Okay? But they in a relationship, they in a third party with somebody else. Because for some of them, they want to celebrate with you, be merry, but it's too much on them because they don't want a commitment. Okay? And for some of them, they in a third party relationship and it's too much on them because they messing around because they want a commitment with you. Okay? Yeah, because all you want is stability. You want things to be stable. You're ready for stability. Okay? But with this moon underneath of it, there's going to be something that's going to be illuminated that's going to crack this foundation. You see how that foundation is cracked? It's going to be something that's illuminated that's going to crack this foundation. Okay? Yeah, something is going to be illuminated. Something's definitely going to be illuminated, but with this magician underneath of the moon, clarifying the moon, you know, you just have to manifest what it is that you want. If you want this, you know, if you want the arguments to stop, you need to manifest that. If you're ready for this person to come back with the offer, you need to manifest that. If you're ready for this person to come back to you to make this passionate, creative endeavor to you, you know, if you're ready for a passionate, creative endeavor, you need to manifest that. If you're ready for all the sneakiness to be done, you need to manifest that. If you're ready for, you know, a new opportunity in love, you need to manifest that. So that you can get your Ten of Cups. You need to manifest this Ten of Cups. You need to manifest this stability. You need to manifest this commitment. Okay? You need to manifest that. And with the star underneath of that, that's saying for you to have hope and faith. You know? Manifest it. Okay? And have hope and faith that it will come to fruition. Okay? Because we do have somebody coming. Once you manifest that and have hope and faith, we have somebody coming. Like I said, to offer this cup of love to you. What I say? New opportunity in love. They coming. Once you manifest that and have hope and faith, they coming in and offering this cup to you. What I say? Offering. They coming in quick. Offering passion to you. Once you manifest this creative new and passionate endeavor, they're going to come to you, okay? And here comes the financial one, too. They're going to come with a financial opportunity, too. It's going to come with a financial opportunity that's going to transform this situation, okay? That's going to transform this relationship, okay? Yeah. It's going to transform this relationship. All you have to do is just have faith. Have faith. In some of y'all cases, before y'all can get this, before y'all can get, you have to manifest this, okay? In some of y'all cases, y'all still have to manifest this. If this is what you want, you have to have hope and faith that this is what you want. And if this person is dealing with a third-party situation, that's going to end. That's going to end. They're going to come to you with an apology, okay? And then you guys will be able to move forward. You guys will be able to move forward, okay? Because you didn't put in the work. You put the work in. You manifested it. You put the work in. And now you can sit pretty on your throne and be confident and be stable, okay? Like I said, you're dealing with a Taurus, a Virgo, or a Capricorn, okay? Because that's the counterpart to the Queen. But you got to put in the work and you have to manifest it if this is what you want. Okay? Yeah, you have to manifest that if this is what you want, guys. So, I hope this video resonated with you all. And please comment down below and let me know if the video resonated with you. Check your Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus signs to get more information about your video. I mean, you know, about your situation. And subscribe to the channel and like the video if you, you know, feel inclined to do so. And yeah, and don't forget to check out all my info down below if you want a personal reading. And I'll see you guys in my next video.